Welcome. This video has a subject of showing you the effects of using magnets on a wired core system, where the influence of the magnetic fields from the permanent magnets is influencing your coil system. There are various inventors in the past who did work on that subject in various different types, and I did show a couple of them already on a Hubbard coil, for example, that you can indeed influence the performance or the the frequency, phase shifting, all sort of things you can influence by using a magnet, but only to a marginal change. So here in my example, I have wound a special coil as part of my next generation coil. We have two opposite wound primaries which are connected in the middle, and literally this is your ground. That would be a kind of a similar thing which would be in a transformer, where you have a so-called ground in a connected. So I have a 1 kilo ohm load connected here on my measurement meters. So I measure current here and I measure voltage over here. I have two magnets, or two sets of magnets, and I can show you the polarity. So north is here and south is here. So red is north. So see that both are facing north at the moment. I have set it to 3 volts. 3 volts is the minimum I can I have to use for my driver here, and of course I'm using my own signal generator I did build here, and I set it up to the best frequency at the moment at 317 for this combination. As you can see here, this is the highest value I currently get, so you would call it a resonance frequency. So I'm consuming 20 milliampere, which shows in seconds. There's also a no load current requirement, because it's not ideal. I get some new components which will be better, much more efficient. I want to go down almost to zero current draw under no load, but here under these circumstances I cannot go lower than 3 milliampere. That is without load. So we have at the moment 2.29 milliampere current via the 1 kilo ohm, and we measure 2.25 volt. And if I connect now, let's say, the north side of then on one side, we're going to change a couple of things. First of all, our amplitude goes down because we are removing the tuning. My current goes down to 7 milliampere from 21 milliampere. I measure 2 milliampere here and 1.9 volt over there. So that looks quite good. So that is the north side I'm connecting at the moment. Now I change that. And you see, it's only a small change from 2.19 to 1.9, and here from 2.1 volt to 1.9 volt. But however, from 21 milliampere, I go down to 7 milliampere. Now let's see, that was north side. Now let me connect the south side. Looks the same thing. So if I connect one magnet, because it's shifting forward and backward, it doesn't really matter what polarity I use on this one magnet. You see, we have the same thing, 1.9 milliampere and 1.9 volt. And again, here 7 milliampere, and I want to show you that it is 7 milliampere, so that you can see that better. 7 milliampere, and let me remove now the magnet to show you that's 20 milliampere. So 20 milliampere is without the magnet. Let's go back. Okay. Now we're gonna use both magnets. So I go again here, let's say north. I connect north here, right? Now I connect north with two magnets on the other side. So we have an imbalance, an asymmetric imbalance. I connect this one on the other side. I go back up to where I was. Now I have 2.82 milliampere, 2.7 volt, but I don't have 21 milliampere back. I have 16 milliampere back. So it's a slightly better performance than we had before. Now you can tune the circuit, but if you detune the circuit under that circumstance where it was ideal, we might get back to the same value we had before. Let's see. So let's see. Yeah, if I go to that value, you can see I'm back at 21 milliampere. I will zoom in to a second, but I'm at a little bit lower now, 1.84 and 1.79. I'll show you the current requirement on the system. We are back at 21 milliampere. So what a magnet actually does, it detunes, it changes the phase, you can do that, and it allows you to align frequencies to a certain point. However, it's not giving you more energy. I said that before, it does not. Now, let's put that back out. So we have only the other two, we have still 21, so this one doesn't make any difference here on that side. Bear in mind, this side is a side where I pick up the energy, and this side is a side which I energize. So on this side, it has no impact at all because it is not part of the driving circuit, which is this part. That is also very important. But I will go more into the subject on my member website. That's only for you, give you a brief information. I put that back up, and because we are now detuned, completely detuned, I'm on 7 milliampere, 8 milliampere, but here I'm completely out of my perfect point. So I tune it back, I'm back here, and I'm back at my 21 milliampere. Now, this here is my pivotal point to the ground. Now let's have a look. If I influence this here, I can use it actually as a valve. So this is now north. I want to demonstrate that. This is north side. So if I put the north side down, now see what happens. I go down to 60 milliampere, go up to 7, and to 7. It's a much better performance. Now let me change that to south side. I just turn it around. Now we have 12 milliampere here. 2.4 and 2.4. The south side is the ground. Ground is south. I'm actually pulling more on a ground to a higher value with this magnet. And I'm pulling more out and I'm reducing now the current requirement for my driving side. Quite interesting. Now let's do that with two magnets. North side. South side. So I do the north side first. So I go down to 4 milliampere. Wave is completely gone. That means it's stronger because it's also a relationship between the strength of the magnetic fields and the core material you use and the current requirements you put or the current you put in the system. I'm at 1.5 milliampere and 1.4 volt, but I have 4 milliampere here. That's connected to north currently. Now, connected to south. It looks similar. Let's turn it around. At that value, it doesn't make any difference anymore. The magnet is too strong. It pulls it completely down. It's overbalanced. That means it's over the tipping point of making a beneficial difference when the magnet is too strong. I did show that with many of my experiments in the past. I did show that with a driving stern wheel, that a weaker magnet is better than a stronger magnet. If I would use a neodymium magnet here, I would completely destroy the complete magnetic flow. But that should give you an indication in which direction you can experiment. And as you can see, it is unlimited the possibilities you have here. But bear in mind, you're not gaining any energy. You're just changing only frequency and you're changing only phase in a certain extent. You can optimize your system, yes, but it will not go to above the value of a CUP of 1 by using a magnet. And that is my experience I have done with many tests before. However, it is interesting to use it if you have a system which is not at all that good running and you want to have it more efficient. I think that is a way to go about it, to have a more efficient system. But if you detune or retune the system based on what you had here, then you're coming back to the same values as we had before, and it wouldn't make any difference. So you really rebalance it out by changing the frequency, and it would be back to where you have been before. So that's all for now, and hope to see you all on my website. Thank you.